If you follow this channel, you know that building generative AI applications in Java is incredibly easy to do thanks to Spring AI. You go in, you configure an API key, and you're off and running. You can talk to one of the large language models out there. Now, what happens if you want to use two of those large language models in the same application? Again, Spring AI makes this incredibly easy to do. Now, why would you want to do that? I know you're probably thinking the same thing, right? I tell everyone that for your specific use case, it's good to go out and test the different large language models to see which one produces results for your specific type of application. So in this example, maybe I want to use OpenAI's multimodality support to work with images. And on the other side, maybe I have some functionality that needs to generate code or summarize documents. And I find Anthropic's Claude 3.5 Sonnet to be very good at that. So I want to use both of those LLMs in the same application. How can I do it? That's exactly what we're going to do today. So here I am over on GitHub, github.com/DanVega, multiple LLMs. Here is the GitHub repository. I will leave this in the description below. This walks through the minimal amount of code that we're going to go through today. There's not a lot to write, but it does kind of talk through what you need to do to get started with this. First of which is going to be two LLM API keys. Again, I'm using OpenAI's GPT-4o, and I'm also using Anthropic's Claude 3.5 Sonnet. So there's that. I also want to point you to the documentation over at Spring AI. Again, I get a lot of questions like, how can I learn Spring AI? What are some of the best resources out there? The documentation is a really good place to start. I feel like it answers all the questions I have. I had a similar question, like, how can I do this? Because I know that if I just need to talk to a single LLM, you can see here in the documentation, that there's an auto-configured chat client.builder. So I can go ask for an instance of that, use it to build a chat client, and then use the chat client to talk to the LLM, similar to this code right here. But what if I don't want that auto-configured me and I need to set up multiple chat clients? Again, right here in the documentation, it says you can disable the chat client.builder auto-configuration by setting the property spring.ai.chat.client.enabled equal to false. This is useful when multiple chat models are used together. Then create a chat client.builder instance programmatically for every chat model you need. That's what we're going to do, and it couldn't be easier than that. So we're going to get started by heading over to start.spring.io. I'm going to choose Java Maven, the latest version of Spring Boot, which is 3.3.4 at this time. Feel free to use whatever is the latest. I'm going to call this two LLMs, and we'll say, let's get rid of that. And I'm going to use JDK 23. Feel free to use whatever you like. I'm going to create a web app. I'm also going to include OpenAI, so I'm going to come down here and choose this. Now, Anthropic doesn't have a Spring Boot starter, but we still support it in Spring AI. I'll just add a quick dependency in there when we create this app. With that, I'm going to go ahead and click Generate, which is going to download a zip file. I can then go ahead and open that up in whatever text editor or IDE you're most productive in. For me, that's going to be IntelliJ Ultimate Edition. But with that, I think we have everything we need. Let's write some code. All right, so here we are in the application. The first thing that we need to do is set up some properties. The first thing that we're going to set up is that one that we saw in the documentation, which is chat.client.enabled equal to false, because again, we're not going to get one auto-configured for us. We want to manually wire these up ourselves. Then we're going to need to set a few properties. So I'm going to kind of paste these in here so we don't have to watch me type them. But again, these are in the GitHub repo. Oops. So we are setting two properties for OpenAI. We're setting the API key, which you will need to get. I did not hard code this in here because I don't want to leak my credentials, but I have externalized this to a environment variable that I am asking for here. Then I'm saying I'm going to use GPT-4o. I'm setting up my Anthropic API key. So that is now also externalized into an environment variable. And then I am giving it the model that I want to use, which I think you don't even need to do because I think this is the default, but just check the documentation. So with all of those in place, I'm ready to go, but I need to get a chat client because remember, let's start with a simple OpenAI chat controller. So we'll say OpenAI chat controller. And if we create this and we create a REST controller, normally what we would do is say private final chat client, We would ask through this through constructor injection, and then we would ask for the builder, and we would say builder, builder.build, and that would work. But as you can see, we're getting a little squiggly here saying could not auto-wire this. No bean of builder found because we turned that feature off. So we need to get a check client somehow. So what we're going to do is go into a configuration class. I can actually do this right in the main application class because this is configured, or this is annotated with @SpringBootApplication, which is also annotated with @SpringBootConfiguration, which is a configuration class. So basically it's looking for bean definitions. So we're going to provide those two bean definitions, one for OpenAI. So we have a chat client that talks to OpenAI and another one that talks to Anthropic. So we're going to define a bean here. This is going to be a, it's going to return a chat client. That's what we want at the end of the day. I'll call this OpenAI chat client. And the trick here is we're going to take in an argument, and this one is going to be the OpenAI chat model. And I'll show you why in a second. So when we return something here, the chat client has a method on it called create that takes in a chat model. So we want to pass that chat model in. Once we do that, that is going to return a chat model, and we are passing in the appropriate chat model. So now what we get back is a chat client that can talk to OpenAI's GPT. So we'll create one more bean. This is also going to return a chat client. We'll call this the Anthropic chat client. And again, this is going to take in a chat model. So we'll say Anthropic chat model. Oops. Okay, so one thing we didn't do here yet is we didn't add Anthropic to the build. So all we need to do is come down here and add something similar to this. So we'll say dependency. This is going to be Spring AI Anthropic Spring Boot Starter. That is from org.springframework.ai. So let's go ahead and refresh this. And I'll go back into application and I'll say Anthropic chat model, chat model. And again, we can do the same thing here, call chat client.create and pass in the chat model. So now we have our two beans. Now we can ask for those chat clients in the constructor in the appropriate controller that we're going to create for each of them. So in here, let's go back. Let's close this out. Let's close this out. Now in here, instead of asking for this builder, we can just ask for the chat client. Now, this is going to like cause a problem right now because we have two chat clients. There's more than one bean of chat client type. That's okay. We can ask for the right one by using the @qualifier annotation. So all we're doing is giving it the name of the bean that we want. In this case, we want this OpenAI chat client. So we can go ahead and pass that in. And we can just say this.chatClient is equal to chat client. Now we have a chat client that we can work with. Let's go ahead and create a Git mapping. We'll call this OpenAI. And then this is going to return a string, just the response from the LLM. I'll call this OpenAI. And we're going to return the chat client. We're going to say prompt. We're going to pass it a user message. Let's say, tell me an interesting fact about OpenAI. And then we'll go ahead and call the LLM, and we'll go ahead and return the content. So this is going to look pretty familiar for the Anthropic chat model or chat controller. So let's do another one here, Anthropic chat controller. And we'll do something similar here. This is going to be a REST controller. Did we make the other one? Yes, that is also a REST controller. So this is going to be Anthropic chat controller. Now we're going to just change that bean name to the one that we created here. So we'll say that. So now we'll get that one in here. Say Claude, and then tell me an interesting fact about Anthropic. All right. So we have two different endpoints now we can call in our application. And when we call one, it's going to talk to OpenAI, GPT-4 to be specific. And then the other one is going to talk to Claude 3.5 Sonnet. So if we want to, let's go ahead and give this a try. If we run this and everything was configured right, we should be up and running, and we are. All right, and I just noticed one error. Not really an error, but I had the same name for that. I'm going to go ahead and rename that, and let's try this again. I'm going to make an HTTP call to localhost 8080 slash Claude. One interesting fact about Anthropic is that the company was founded by a couple of individuals who previously worked at OpenAI and Google Brain. So there you have it. That's really all I wanted to show. I got a question about this. How can I talk to two different LLMs in the same application? And it is easy as that. Letting the auto configuration back off. Again, I think this comes into play in most Spring applications, right? Auto configuration is great. It will set things up for you when you need them. In this case, I want it to back off. We disabled that. We said, I'm going to provide my own configuration of beans because I need two different chat clients. We configure them here. You can put them in a separate configuration class if you want to. And that's all there is to it. We have two chat clients that we can use to talk to two different providers. Again, the only thing you want to pay attention to is make sure you set that enabled equal to false, and then go ahead and set this up. This would work for whatever you want it to work for. You could talk to four or five different LLMs if you needed to, but you just need to configure each individual LLM in here, the API key, the model. Those are kind of the basics. There are a lot more things that you can configure, things like temperature and max tokens that you want to look at the documentation for. But I think that is a really good place to end this video. Again, if you want, the GitHub repo is here. I'll leave that in the description below. With that, you know what time it is, friends. It is time to get out of here, but I need your help with one little thing. If you can help me out, and I know you will, do me a big favor. Go ahead and leave this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and as always, happy coding.